In the 50s and 60s, researchers studying the behavior of captive gray wolves witnessed them fighting for dominance. The winner of these aggressive displays was thought of as the alpha. In dog training, this alpha and dominance theory is often seen as a natural way of interacting with dogs. The thinking goes, because dogs and wolves share a common ancestor, that they probably have other things in common. Here's the problem. These studies were dog s***. In 1999, the scientist who popularized the term alpha male formally disavowed the terminology and called his original publications misinterpretations of incomplete data. And today, wildlife biologists have dropped the term alpha altogether.
The term alpha isn't really accurate when describing most of the leaders of wolf packs, because the term implies that the wolves fought and competed strongly to get to the top of the pack. In actuality, the way they get there is merely by mating with a member of the opposite sex, producing a bunch of offspring, which are the rest of the pack then, and becoming the natural leaders that way, just like with a pair of humans producing a family.
I'm KP, a marine biologist who specializes in animal behavior. I've trained sea lions and walruses to do research behaviors, voluntary blood samples, and healthcare behaviors like eye drops. But whenever I do a video on dogs, I always get comments like, stick to fish, or that I've never owned a dog. So this time, I'm calling in some backup.
Hi, I'm Jesse Ciletti. I am the owner and lead trainer for Blueprints Dog Training, and I am a certified behavioral canine consultant through the Certification Council of Professional Dog Trainers.
Ciletti, can you explain the basic idea behind dominance training?
Yeah, so dominance training suggests that dogs are pack animals and they have that natural instinct to form social hierarchies within a group. So for dog training to be effective, the owner must establish themselves as the alpha or the pack leader.
So what does dominance training actually look like?
Dominance training uses verbal, physical corrections, alpha roles. They limit the dog's freedom in so many scenarios. Owners just assume that the dog is always trying to assert dominance or be the alpha in so many scenarios.
Earlier, I talked about how dominance theory arose from 50 or 60 year old studies of captive wolves, but the scientists involved in those studies have since agreed that their conclusions were invalid because their methods were deeply flawed.
Because the studies that you talked about, they put all these captive wolves in unnatural circumstances with limited resources. The wolves were all males, all unrelated, and that's not normal. Groups for wolves to be in a natural environment, wolves tend to actually form cooperative groups, similar to a family setting. So the entire premise of that is based on unnatural circumstances.
Up-to-date research of wild wolves shows that packs usually consist of a breeding pair and their offspring. These offspring will remain with their parents for 1 to 3 years, learning how to hunt and even help raise new litters of pups.
Instead of using the term alpha for a wolf, instead of saying alpha male or alpha female, scientists now tend to call wolves like that the breeding male and the breeding female. Or you can call them the mother wolf and the father wolf. There's really nothing wrong with that. Those are much better and more accurate terms than the term alpha.
Recent studies also found that they don't fight over resources like food, shelter, or mating opportunities, and actually avoid conflict whenever possible. When resources are scarce, wolves will simply split into smaller groups and spread out across a wider range of land. In fact, when the author who originally coined and later disavowed the term alpha began studying wild wolves, over the 13 years of summer observations, he witnessed no dominance contests between individuals. Let that sink in. Zero dominance contests over 13 years. Sources and links to these studies and quotes are all down in the descriptions below, along with a link to Ciletti's Blueprints Dog Training website. So now that we've debunked the basis for dominance theory, maybe you can talk about the negative impacts of this kind of training and why it's so harmful.
Yeah, corrective training can instill a lot of fear and anxiety in dogs, and that anxiety can cause a lot of behavioral issues. Dogs that are fearful can become even more aggressive or actually very withdrawn. And a dog that feels threatened can actually lash out defensively at any time.
That highlights another flaw with dominance theory. Thinking an aggressive dog is trying to be dominant or alpha completely ignores the fact that unwanted behaviors like aggression are often born out of fear, anxiety, stress, or even serious medical issues like pain or illness.
Exactly. Understanding the root cause of a behavior is critical in reducing these behavioral issues, especially those severe issues like anxiety or aggression.
I imagine dominance theory can also make a dog less trusting of its owner.
Dominance-based training can absolutely erode a dog's trust in its owner. These methods can have a really negative impact on training and actually hinder the dog's learning and ability to learn. If a dog is focused on trying to escape punitive measures, they're not going to be more apt to be learning in that scenario.
I'm guessing that dogs trained using dominance-based methods might even become unpredictable since they're responding out of fear.
Yeah, and this unpredictability can lead to dangerous situations, especially if the dog's fear is triggering that scenario. The other thing to talk about is behavioral suppression. So with these corrective methods, the behavior may look like it's fixed, but the dog is just stopping the behavior to escape that aversiveness. So the dog actually hasn't learned what to do instead. It's just escaping that negative consequence.
So what training methods should pet owners use instead of trying to dominate their animal?
The same techniques that you and I use when working with marine mammals, which is positive reinforcement.
Positive reinforcement training essentially uses a reward for desired behaviors.
Good boy!
Rewards like treats, praise,
good job! You did it! Yay!
Toys, or anything that the animal enjoys. According to the Humane Society, because the reward makes them more likely to repeat the behavior, positive reinforcement is one of your most powerful tools for shaping or changing your dog's behavior. So instead of only teaching your dog what you don't want them to do, teach them what you do want them to do, and then reward that behavior.
So he jumps, I remove my hands, I ignore him the entire time he's jumping on me, and then when he sits, I go down and I reward him, give him all the attention.
Because if Ciletti and I can use positive reinforcement to give alert and unrestrained sea lions eye drops, or take blood samples from a seal, or brush their teeth, then you don't need to use harmful dominance theory with your dog. Another huge problem I see with this dominance theory is dogs aren't wolves, right? Sure, dogs and wolves share a common ancestor, but they evolved into a completely different species after thousands of years of selective breeding. Wolves didn't evolve to live with humans like dogs have. They have significant differences in their behavior, ecology, and physiology. It just doesn't make sense to use outdated misinformation about wild wolves when you're training domestic dogs. What do you think? Let me know down in the comments. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. And don't forget to check out the website for Ciletti's Blueprints Dog Training, link in the descriptions. In 1999, the scientist who popularized. But whenever I do a video on dogs, I always get comments like "stick to fish" and that I've never owned a dog.
Can you do those the quotes without the funny voice?
They need the funny voice.
I can use the funny voice too, but I just want to have a regular one too.